inspecting the network traffic. What we're going to do here is we're not going to jump into Ajax code or syntax. What we're going to do is we're going to use an Oracle Application Express example and some Ajax traffic that was generated by some of the declarative aspects of Apex. Specifically, we're going to show you a department drop-down list, and when that value changes, the list of employees that comes back from the server is either the sales or accounting or research department. So that is an example of a cascading list of values that is based in Ajax under the hood. And then when you click on an employee name, you get their salary back, which is again another Ajax call that was defined by a declarative dynamic action within Oracle Application Express. So let's have a look at that so we can see that in action. Okay, I've got a little application here. Let's have a look at this. Let's run the application. This is a Oracle Application Express application. Let's keep this. Let's run it again. So we're just going to concentrate here on department, employee name, and salary. And so what happens here, if I select the sales department, we end up with a list of salespeople. If I select accounting, we get a list of accountants. And if I select an employee, I get their salary. And that was all done without doing a full page refresh. And as I said earlier, a full page refresh is very expensive on the server side. And you really don't want to do that if you have hundreds or thousands of users using your application. You want things to be as efficient as possible. So one of the first things you want to do, this is all working here. It's fine. It's very simple. But if you do have some sort of complicated Ajax call that's doing something sophisticated and it's not working correctly, one of the first things you want to do is isolate the bug either to your client-side code in your browser or on your server side. And the first thing you want to do there is inspect the network traffic that's going back and forth to make sure that the values you're passing back and forth are in fact correct. And the web developer tool allows you to inspect that traffic. So let's have a look. First, let me shrink this down a little bit so we can see a bit better. And we can right click here almost anywhere. And here our tool comes up. And we're not interested in the elements tab here. Funny enough, since we're looking for network traffic, we want to look on the network tab. Okay, and right now, since we've just brought this up, there's nothing here. And so when I click sales, we've got something. Looks like a breakpoint in the Apex code. Let's just click on that to bang through the code, and let's get back to the network tab. And you can see here, now we've got a post that resulted from our click on the development. So let's inspect that by clicking here on the WV Flow Show. And let's go to the header subtab here. Now there's a lot of information here. It goes on and on and on here. What we want to do is let's collapse this request headers because we're really not interested in that. There's something down here below called response headers. We're not interested in that. What we want to look at is the form data. This is the data that gets passed from the client to the server. And it's a little bit confusing here. You see here this pflow ID. It is actually, in fact, our application ID. I think if you can see up here, here's the, in the developer toolbar, application 444. This sort of leads into a little bit of a history lesson here with the Oracle Application Express. Back in 1999, year 2000, in that era, Application Express was actually known as Flows. That was the name inside Oracle at the time. And a flow actually was an application. Here we have Flow Step. The pages in that application were actually at the time known as steps. And that old, old terminology actually has survived under the hood in the Apex source code. So that's why you see that funny flow and step stuff down here. But there's the application ID 444, and we're on page 2. Now, the interesting stuff is really not that. That is kind of like the housekeeping stuff. What I want to show you down here is the name value pairs here that are being passed to the server. And this department drop-down list here that's got sales in it, it's actually P2 underscore depno. And the value that's being passed for the sales department is actually 30. And so when you do have problems with your Ajax calls, one of the first things you do is you inspect the network traffic to make sure that these values are in fact correct. So this is the traffic going to the server. Now if I click on the response, I see the reply from the server. And you can see here's the list of names that belong to the sales department. Let's see if that's right. Yeah, Blakey, James, Martin, Turner, and Ward, with their corresponding primary key IDs here. And again, if you have problems, what you want to do is inspect this data very carefully to make sure that things are being passed back correctly. If something is wrong here, it might indicate that you've got a problem on your server-side code. One more tab here that's kind of interesting. If you're dealing with a performance issue, you can look here and you can get a feel for the timing of your network calls. So this also is a very useful useful tab. Okay, so let's select a Blakey here, and we'll see, whoops, there's that breakpoint again. That's in the Apex area. And now we've got another show here. Let's click on that. And since we've asked for Blakey's salary, let's have a look. Let's collapse this header business just to review the process. Collapse the response headers because we're not interested. Here we have the P2 EMPNO. That's the employee drop-down together with the primary key. You inspect that. Make sure that that is correct. You look at the response. There's the 3000 and then the timing page. So that is inspecting Ajax network traffic.